So for Wednesday, April 1st, our home workout to start out for part A, we have a hang power snatch EMOM. The hang power snatch EMOM, you can use either your barbell weight, you have your dumbbell, kettlebell option, and then you even have the option with a PVC pipe, broomstick, or any apparatus that can help mimic a barbell. When using a dumbbell for the hang power snatch, you want to make sure that the dumbbell faces left and right. You hinge forward, drop in between the legs. You're firing your elbow as high as you can and finishing through your wrist. Pulling yourself down slightly, resetting to butt back. If you have a kettlebell, you'll be doing the hang power snatch with your kettlebell today. So in terms of setup, you actually always want to turn the thumb inward. Still same concept, elbows high, and you're going to actually, as you punch, you're going to rotate the kettlebell. Just to help avoid the slamming on the forearm. So for part B, we follow the same exact flow like we just did in the hang power snatch, but now with the hang power clean, every minute on the minute. When it comes to the hang power clean, same thing like the hang power snatch, I want you to focus on the dumbbell facing left and right. It drops in between the legs. As we come up now though, elbow high, then through each time. The hang power clean. If you have a kettlebell, you'll be performing your repetitions with your kettlebell. Same concept of just like the hang power snatch. Thumb in, elbow high, you're gonna rip the elbow through nice and fast. So, thumb in, whipping the elbow through. Another good alternative, if you happen to have a ball at your house, it happens to be a wall ball, medicine ball, or just any kind of ball, you can still help mimic the hang power clean with this portion. It's going to end up teaching you how to focus on still pulling up and not curling the weight, keeping the weight nice and close to you and whipping the elbows through to help mimic a barbell and the concept of the hang power clean as best as possible. So I have my writing facing up. If I were to curl, the writing will end up facing me. I always want the writing to stay facing towards the ceiling. Same concept, I hinge, I rotate, I reset. For part C, our WOD today will end up being for time. Our three movements that we have today are the thruster, glute bridges, and the double number. If you don't have a barbell for the thruster, you're gonna be using the dumbbell. Dumbbell rests on the shoulder, full squat, big punch overhead. For the thruster, can end up using your kettlebell. Kettlebell rest on the outside, same concept, full squat, big punch overhead. So let's say you don't have a barbell, dumbbell, kettlebell for your thrust for today. Feel free to use any object that's gonna allow you to squat down and press up overhead. I'll be showing you guys with a backpack today. Feel free to use a water jug, anything. You can use books, you can use two water bottles if you really wanted to. Whatever it is that's gonna help you mimic the thruster as best as possible for today. Thank you.